Let's see. Bruno Savini, male, 18. Subject suffers from phonophobia. What is that? Once hospitalized for electrical burns, and since then he avoids electricity. Efforts by psychologists to help him out with his childhood trauma have proven unsuccessful. Added info.
Oh, God.
All right. I'm going to try to get a bit more comfortable here. All right. As a child, Bruno Savini was a competitive swimmer and placed in dozens of competitions. He gave up the sport after an unpleasant experience after he finished swimming lessons one evening. Some girls locked him inside his locker and left him alone there all night. Since then, he has repeatedly appeared to appealed to psychologists to help him with his fear of dark and closed spaces. He was also regularly exposed to violence at home. After the death of his parents in an automobile accident, Bruno Savini dedicated himself to his studies and graduated high school with honors. He received a scholarship to a prestigious college where he was counted one of the three best students. He also took several side jobs while he was in school. One of these jobs was at Tala Funeral Home. He met Dante Gambino. They have since grown close. Mr. Gambino has assisted Savini in the past, bailing him out when Savini got into major jams. He's even listed as Savini's emergency contact. Okay. Well, we have some fears and we have some general things to compliment him on. Who do you work for? Follows one great head. Okay, so let's go. Who do you work for? Okay, so we already know you're in with Dante Gambino. He works for you, or is it the other way around? How about we simplify your life and help us out a little bit? Your mother isn't happy about what's going on. She just called. No, both of his parents died, so that's not... Listen, you're young and clever. You help us and we'll help you. We'll put in a good word for you. You might even get to go to college after all. He graduated college. So it's this one. That's the first time hearing his name. Liar. That's not it. Liar. He bailed you out of here. You'd be a fool to deny it. We record everything. A liar envelope contains photos of surveillance cameras showing. No. Okay, so I believe it's this one. Okay, fine. I'll tell you what happened. Okay, I'll tell you everything. It was Dante Gambino. I got the drugs from him. I just did what he asked. Okay. Start investigation. Fuck. Okay, wait. Detectives, I want someone... We'll go ahead and put a couple of other people on and close it. And then I want to go gangs. Start investigation. Proceed. Not what I meant to do. This. This is what I want. City Hall. So I need another officer slot.
11A.
Noise from a garbage truck woke up a vagabond who was sleeping on a nearby bench. The homeless became angry and went to scold the truck driver. A fight soon erupted. Wait, what? Woke up. Oh, that's all it did was The garbage truck woke him up. That's fucking ridiculous. Like, seriously, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you guys have a hard life, but you can't get mad at people for doing their fucking jobs, even if it's an inconvenience to you. I'm sorry. Truly I am, but still. Let's see. Jose... is that Muma? I'm gonna say Muma. Reported a run-in with a pickpocket at the park. His wallet was stolen along with some documents and an expensive watch. I'm sure it was the red-haired brat he was rubbing all over me. Let's see, fight. Escaped. Good fucking job, guys. And then we have drug possession, which still needs to be worked on some. And let's see for the hit and run details. I'm pretty sure we have everything we need. So I'm going to mess with this some, and I will be back. Alright, I'm going to take a gamble that we don't have all the necessary pieces. And I'll try again in a bit. Let's try the double homicide. Do we have... so we technically have three, but, I mean, here's the thing. I highly doubt that these six perfectly align with our scenario. So I'm just gonna wait on this. Sitting quietly on the bench is a red-haired guy who fits the description, but in the distance, there's a woman struggling with a young man in a hood, shouting and clutching her bag. Keep an eye on the other suspects. Rush to the woman and the guy in the hoods. Rush to... unfortunately, we have clear evidence of a crime in process. So we're going to rush to the woman. The guy in the hoodie notices the police and tries to escape. He stumbles and several wallets and pieces of jewelry come tumbling out of his pockets. Try to chase the fleeing man down, walk over to the bench. No. Shoot the fleeing man with a taser. 9/11. There we go. So, what's this? Fraud. Hello, I was contacted by a lawyer named Donald Horton Jr. who told me some wonderful news. It turns out I'm a distant relative of a Nigerian prince who recently died, and he left me $15 billion. I only need to pay $20,000 in gold... bullion to open an account to receive the money. But I noticed that the lawyer carries a pistol, so I decided to play it safe and call a police escort to make sure everything goes smoothly. It's a fucking scam. But at the very least, we can, you know, arrest the guy that's running the scam, so okay. I feel like he's failed every assignment. Let's go. No, wait, that one's right. Fire. Oh, too old, but he hasn't failed three assignments in a row, so we'll wait. Phyllis Emery is clearly beside himself. This jerk took out his crooked dick in the middle of a crowded bus and started to poke me with it. God, it was so disgusting, I screamed, and several of the men on the bus grabbed the pervert and wrestled him to the ground. Good for them. This is his test. If he fails this one too, he's out. No one was harmed, but we didn't get any loot, which kind of sucks. City Hall had a wall repainted by some hooligans. If police can't do their jobs in a timely manner and send these criminals to prison, then they can spend their shift cleaning the wall. Alright, fine. Here's the officers. Happy? Public indecency. Alright, good job. So, I mean, there's definitely some interesting stuff going on with this game. I'm unsure how I feel about it as a whole, though. Let's see, an eyewitness saw a man in a pickup truck cruising down a road, stopping at every parked car and siphoning off the fuel into the spare tanks he carried in the back. The passerby went up to him, but saw the guy had a gun and ran. That was the smart thing to do. We'll send three. An elderly man called the station in a rage. I went to the drugstore to buy a hearing aid and some pain reliever, and the guy behind the counter tried to sell me cocaine. I don't know if I believe that, but we'll send a couple. We'll send a couple of cops out there. Armed robbery. An armed man entered a publishing office and demanded a copy of the new novel by writer Ivan Baikov, which had just gone to press. Alright, we'll send the two cops plus the SWAT team. And I'm out! I am out of people. Unless some can get back in time, which I highly doubt. The suspect has been sighted. He's squatted down next to someone's car. One end of the hose in the gas tank, the other end of the hose in the suspect's mouth. Apparently he's trying to siphon fuel. Draw weapons and slowly approach the suspect. Sneak up behind him and strike a match. That is fucking stupid. Take the hose out of your mouth and put your hands up. He sees the police and quickly pulls out a gun from his rear holster. He shoots wildly and misses. Shoot the man, shoot the gas tank, rush the suspect and tackle him. Well, here's the thing. Guns do use gunpowder. Well, that's what's in the bullets, I should say. So, like, that's just gonna cause a fire. We're gonna rush him. 9-11. And I really need some people here. The old man has a hearing problem. The pharmacist was explaining that the old man's Vicodin prescription had expired and he mistakenly heard something about cocaine. And see, if I could just send one person, I would have had... Oh my god. The man fires his shotgun into the air and yells at the editor, "Better bring me that fucking book right now or you'll be the hero in tomorrow's obituaries." Shoot the criminal with the taser. Ask the editor for a second copy of the book. You there, throw down your weapon or you'll be reading all about it in the morgue. Shoot him with the taser. Alright, we got it. Bye. And I'm not gonna get to the carjacking. which pisses me off. Yep. They escaped. With any luck, though, I might be able to get to the other one. An assault with a deadly weapon. During a performance, someone began shouting racist speech at a black singer and then fired several shots from a pistol. The room descended into panic and everyone ran for the exits. Send the paddy wagon and two cops. Oh my god, fine. Fine, all three. The only three fucking officers I have at the moment. God, I hate how I can't just send people with based on how I perceive the situation to be. Like, sometimes it's pretty clear that it's going to be, like, not a serious thing. Like, the man with the fucking cocaine thing, that was pretty clear. That the guy was probably, had probably misheard. One cop could have been able to handle that, no fucking problem. But no, I have to send two, which is just fucking stupid. A passerby reported a dark sedan speeding through red lights, swerving from side to side. He's got to be drunk or stoned. Just thought you might want to know. Wilson, too. And some of our officers are highly competent. Like, one should easily be plenty to deal with. Okay, that's only three. Yes, we'll send another two. But now I'm out of cops again. So I hope nothing else happens. The police cruiser caught up with the sedan, which is swerving dangerously all over the road. Stopped the engine immediately, followed behind, run the sedan into the curb. The sedan suddenly turns into an underground parking garage. Follow him, head up the other way. Tell the attendant to... Oh, damn it. I want to lock all exits. But I found some pharmaceuticals. So sell that to the mafia. And at least the day has ended. Now we're gonna declare him dead, because I hate working understaffed. Freiburg mail truck missing, girl sets house fire to watch firefighters. Mayor Rogers, I will bring order to the police station. So he did not show up to work today. The last few months I've been taking antidepressants. I'm going to allow it. My kid's been causing trouble again and they've called me in to his school. Can you give me some time to deal with this? I'm sorry, I can't. I'll go ahead and give him a stripe. This is just going to be my go-to one right now. I guess I could look at the catalog at some point. I'll do that tomorrow. Let's see. Request results. Cannot meet your request at this time. Fuck off. This is why I can't... Oh, score. Yeah, I'm taking all of that. And we are going to hire someone new for the B shift.